What's up? Mirte here, and in this video, we will be going through the fascia you will find in the thoracic region. Alright, so here is the plain anterior view of the thorax, and here we will add the main muscles associated with the thoracic region. So in this video, we're mainly going to cover the pectoral fascia, the clavipectoral fascia, thoracic fascia, and endothoracic fascia. So these are the fascias we're going to go through, and we will start with the pectoral and the clavipectoral fascia. These two fascias are pretty simple. The pectoral fascia covers the pectoralis major, as you see here in blue, and the clavipectoral fascia covers the subclavius muscle and the pectoralis minor, which are both located underneath the pectoralis major. The clavipectoral fascia is stretched between the clavicle, coracoid process, and the cartilaginous ends of the ribs, as you see here. These two fascias you see here are considered as the superficial fascia of the thorax. So when we remove them, we will see the actual anterior wall of the thorax. The whole external surface of the thorax is covered by a fascia called the thoracic fascia, as you see here. So again, it's a fascia that lies over the surface of the ribs and the intercostal spaces. The other fascia is associated with the internal surface of the thoracic wall. So let's look at the thorax from this perspective, and here we still have the thoracic fascia in orange. The inner surface of the thoracic cavity is covered by a fascia called the endothoracic fascia, as you see here in red. But there are a couple of things that we need to know about the endothoracic fascia. So let's add the diaphragm and look at the thorax from an anterior view, and then cut the thorax like this and look at it from this perspective. We will see this. So again, here's the endothoracic fascia. Now the endothoracic fascia is going to cover the diaphragm as well, and get the name the diaphragmatic fascia, which is just a fancy name for the diaphragmatic part of the endothoracic fascia. Another thing the endothoracic fascia is going to form is a supraplaveral membrane, which is the thickest part of the endothoracic fascia that lies on top of the pleural cupola. Now, if you're unsure about what the pleura is, it's basically just a covering around the actual lungs. And the upper part of the pleura is what we call the pleural cupola. So the endothoracic fascia is going to cover the pleural cupola and form a membrane. So that was all the main fascia of the thorax, and I hope that was helpful.